I like to dedicate this to all of the Creator's righteous children. I have some food in my bag for you. Not that edible food, the food you eat? No. I have some food for thought. Since knowledge is infinite, it has infinitely fell on me. So, it was a stormy night. You know the kind where the lightning strikes. And I was hanging out with some of my artsy friends. Ooh, you, you. The night was long, the night went on. We were cooling out until the break of dawn. Was burning, so I'm feeling right. I see, I pick my friends like a pick of fruit. Again, he told me that when I was only you, I don't walk around trying to be what I'm not. I don't waste my time trying to get what you got. I work at pleasing me, cause I can't please you, and that's why I do what I do. So flash free like a willow tree. Do we, do we, do we? And if you don't want to be down with me, you don't want. And if you don't want to be down with me, then you don't want to pick from my apple tree. And if you don't want to be down with me, then you don't want to pick from my apple tree. And if you don't want to be down with me, you just don't want to be down. I have a home, and I take it everywhere I go. Cause I'm planting seeds, so I reap what I sow, you know, oh. But he's moving like a rolling stone. I can't control the soul flowing in me. Ooh-wee. See, I picked my friends like a big fruit. Again, he told me that when I was only you. I don't walk around trying to be with the night. I don't waste my time trying to get what you got. I work at pleasing me cause I can't please you. And that's why I do what I do. So flash free like a willow tree. Do-wee, do-wee, do-wee. And if you don't want to fit down, and if you don't want to be down with me, you don't want to pick from my apple tree. And if you don't want to be down with me, you don't want to pick from my apple tree. And if you don't want to be down with me, you just don't want to be down. On my, my mind. On my, my mind. Again, he told me that when I was only you. I don't walk around trying to be with the night. I don't waste my time trying to get what you got. I work at pleasing me, cause I can't please you. And that's why I do what I do. So flash free like a willow tree. Do we, do we, do we? And if you don't want to fit down with me, you don't want to pick for my apple tree. And if you don't want to fit down with me, you don't dumb diddy. And if you don't want to fit down with me, you don't want to pay for my apple tree. And if you don't want to fit down with me, you just don't want to fit down.
Some Erykah Badu. What? I pick my friends like I pick my fruit. Highlanders, what it do? Man, I pick my friends like I pick my fruit. What's up, Melanated Agenda, Angelica? Man, a bit tight, Gary in the house. What it do? Man, I'm so happy that New Era King. Peace in the LBC. Man, I'm over here feeling real good. You know what I mean? It's a good day. Did all the things I was supposed to do in a day. And now I'm here with y'all. the Highlanders, and it brings joy to me. And I'm gonna be up here spinning it like a 1959 transistor radio at all times. But maybe not so much today, because today I have an interview with Sister Noble. Now, Sister Noble is a queen in her own right, doing her own thing. I don't know if she belongs to one sect or another, but you might know her, you know, from her previous alignments and so on and so forth. We're not going to mention no names, but you know what I'm saying? Sister Noble. And so she wants to come and clear up some things, have a communication about her back and forth with Black Sun, why she, you know, communicates with him at times and why she doesn't communicate with him at times. And this has been an interest to a lot of people, right? My sister Abitai asked the question in the chat. Some other people asked the question. And so we're going to get the answer today. And so let me, without further ado, I'm going to give Sister Noble on the line. What? Hey, Sister Noble, what it do? Are you there? What happened? I don't see her.
I'm here.
Oh, hey. How's it going today?
How you doing? Bring Aaliyah in. She coming in.
Well, we agreed, right, that this is going to be a conversation between me and you. So I'm not going to lay anybody up right now. Nobody, none of the Highlanders, nobody else. It's just going to be me and you talking about this specific topic, which you brought to me, which is that you want to explain, or at least, I don't know, tell mm-hmm. people about why you communicate with Black Sun, you know, off and on as you do, or have okay. done.
Well, I want to start. Can you share a video? I want to start there, and then it's going to be a very short clip that I want to share.
About your very communication
with him? No. My video, Taz and Black Sun Showdown, where he was on my channel.
Oh,
where I brought
okay.
him on my channel on April 19th
okay.
to clear his name, if he is indeed innocent. And also to clear up some misconceptions and lies that I heard spoken about me on another channel. I wanted him to clear up those misconceptions and those lies about me. Okay.
Okay. Well, can we do this? Because I want to refrain.
I made
please.
Him. Let me
no,
finish. I made a last minute decision to bring him on my channel on the 19th of April at 7:20 p.m. I decided to bring him on my channel because at first I saw him, you know, when I saw him on this other person's channel, and she said the things that she said about me, he asked me to come on my channel, and I told him no at first. But I was the one that made a last minute decision around 7:20 p.m. April 19 to bring him on my channel.
Okay. Well, I want to refrain from playing any video. What I want to do is just have the conversation.
So okay, let's have the conversation.
You had a last minute.
Yeah. Let's have this conversation.
In your mind, last minute, you decided to go ahead and allow him on your channel, correct?
Yeah, but let me answer your other question. I think you had another question, but yeah, I made the decision. I made the decision to bring him on my channel on April 19th, 7:20 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I made the decision to bring him on my channel myself. Me, myself, and I. Okay.
Okay.
Nobody else.
Okay.
Okay. To bring him on my channel on April 19th at 7:20, because I wanted him to clear up his name, to clear his name if he is indeed innocent. Okay. Of what just me said that he did. And I also wanted him to clear up the misconceptions and the lies that he told on me.
Okay.
Along with this other
person. Let me stop you right there. Right.
On her channel. Yes.
Okay. Let me stop you right there.
Yeah.
So you brought him on the channel, right, to clear up the allegations that just me brought towards him, and for you to clear his name
to clear
up,
his
any,
name.
Any allegations.
To clear his name up, for him to clear his own name up, because I cannot clear anybody's name up.
No, I mean about what about you? Though? I'm saying you in relation to you too.
Oh,
what
you
was
mean the
purpose?
Misconceptions and the lies that I heard him speak, and also her speak on her channel on April 19th. Yes, I wanted him to clear up the misconceptions and the lies that I heard about me.
Oh, okay. Calm down. I'm following you.
I just wanted that.
You wanted him to clear up the misconception. So did you want him to, I don't know what he said about you specifically, but it sounds to me that maybe you wanted him to apologize to you.
Well, no, not just apologize. I wanted him to clear up his name since he is so innocent of this allegation. I want him to clear up his name and also clear up the misconceptions and the lies that I heard spoken about me.
So what was more important
was that he clear up his own name, because I can't clear up his name for him. He has to clear up his own name.
I think you're missing what I'm saying.
Okay.
What was the most important thing? Was it the fact you wanted him to clear his name of the JM situation, or you getting some resolve with him? Which one was the most important?
No, I wanted him to clear his name with the JM situation. Mm-hmm. I wanted him to clear his name with the JM situation, not to get some resolve with me.
But how could he clear his name when there is an actual report? So how could he clear his name? In what way did you want him to clear his name?
I wanted him to clear up his name. That's all I'm telling you.
Okay, so then my second question would be,
I don't know what else to say other than my second question would be,
okay, well, this is my second question, right?
Mm-hmm.
You and Blackson have had a back and forth, right?
Yeah.
And you have professed out your mouth that he was a predator and some other things, right? You mm-hmm. have said this. Mm-hmm. Why would you? And so when you have a predator, there implies there was prey. So that would make you mm-hmm. the prey, right?
Yes.
So why would you want to entertain clearing his name in any kind of way? Like, why would you be vested that way? Well, why? Because see, if you know and had an experience with him that was not a good experience, then you would be the person that would know the most that this is possible. You know, it's possible for something to go this way. So why?
You know what?
And plus, you would be the victim in it, right? So why would you care?
I was buying his lies and manipulation. I'm gonna be real with you, because when me and Aaliyah had our first conference call with him, we interrogated mm-hmm. him. This was after Just Me came on Suave's channel on March 18th, you know, and told people that he sexually assaulted
her. Let's call
her
JM. Let's try to stay there.
Yeah, this was after she appeared on Suave's channel on March 18th. We did a conference call, me and Aaliyah,
okay.
both.
Okay.
Where
okay.
we interrogated
him. So after she was
on the show. Okay. So
JM was on the show, right?
Yeah,
after JM
yeah.
was on a particular show.
Mm-hmm.
Then you guys had a conference call with her, you and Aaliyah.
Yes, we did.
Okay.
No, not with her. Not with
just okay. you guys together.
Me
you and, Aaliyah.
And Aaliyah had a conference call with Blackson. We're not talking about Just Me.
Okay.
We're talking about Blackson.
All right.
Okay?
I'm following you now. I'm following
yes.
you. And so still, why would you want a conference call with him when you see? This is the thing.
Yeah, but see, Aaliyah called him. Aaliyah reached out to him. It's actually Aaliyah reached out to him. Okay, and that's how I got involved, you know, with a conference.
Well, why did she reach? Do you know why she reached?
Because she wanted to let him know, yeah, nigga, now, you know, you see they done set you up, nigga. She left him a voicemail message. Okay?
Why would he be set up?
And no, see, she left him a voicemail message.
Did she say set up,
though? Yeah, nigga, yeah, they done set you up. Now, you see
well,
now?
Why is it a setup? I'm confused. Why would it be a setup?
Okay, yeah. You'd have to ask her that, okay? You'd have to ask Aaliyah that.
I'm just going to say this.
Okay.
I would say that if a man traveled, right, to a place
mm-hmm.
and something went down and then a police report came about, right? Mm-hmm. We're all aware. I've seen it with my own eyes.
Yeah.
Has came about, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where's the setup?
Okay, like, you'd have to ask her that. I'm the wrong person to ask. You're going to have to ask her that. Why was she thinking that? Why was she thinking, yeah, nigga, they done set you up. They done set you up. You know, you'd have to ask her that. You're asking the wrong person.
Okay. So what, beyond that, right, beyond that situation, mm-hmm. why do you engage in any kind of communication with them?
you know, that is something that I have considered since I first heard it yesterday. Mm-hmm. And I'm gonna tell you right now that, you know, I shouldn't be talking to him. I shouldn't be talking to him because I have a case on him. But my case is not the same as Just Me's case. My case is
Let's call JM, please.
Okay. JM.
Yeah.
My case is totally different from her case. You don't know my case. I think you know my case, but I don't think you really know my case. You know what I mean? You may have heard bits and pieces here, but then again, a lot of people dismissed everything I said, you know, when I was first talking about it. When I first came out and told people that this nigga is talking about, I did a sex tape with him back in 2013. And, you know, I told people he was slandering me then. I told people that right there, he said he did a sex tape. And I'm like, but I did not know anything about it. But then he said to people on this other person's channel on December 3rd and December 10, 2021, that, yeah, I did put down my cell phone, but I had hidden cameras around my apartment recording her.
Right.
That was then the first time on, I heard it on that person's that channel on that, December right? 3rd.
Later
say
on.
What?
Later on, right? He said that he was lying to you, like that he didn't.
Yeah,
do that.
He said it. Actually, he recanted everything he said. He recanted everything he said originally on December 10 and December 3rd, because he first told people on December 3rd that he did a sex tape with me back in 2013.
So your case,
okay,
is,
without
your
my
case
knowledge,
is, your
without
case
my
is,
knowledge.
So your case, right?
Yeah,
is basically about slander.
Well, no, ma'am.
Where
no, ma'am.
Case is,
no,
is
ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay,
it's not about slander.
Okay.
My case is about pornographic images produced without my consent and without my knowledge back in 2013. It's not about slander.
Did you have any?
Okay.
Okay, calm down.
All right, it's not about slander.
Calm
down. It's about producing pornographic images
without
my consent, without my knowledge.
You need to calm down.
Okay.
Because I'm just asking.
Yes.
We're having an interview, so calm down.
Yes.
Let me ask you this question. So, that would be the case, right? So did you have any proof of it that actually happening?
Ma'am, I don't have any video proof.
Okay.
I'm going by what he said.
All right.
I'm going by statements that he made on December 3rd and December 10th. How many times am I going to tell this story?
You don't have to tell it. You're telling it to me and I'm just following you with it. So since you're going there, I'm following along with you.
Yeah, but how many times am I going to have to keep telling the same thing before people get it? I'm going based on what he said.
Then it depends, right? It depends.
On December 3rd and December 10th.
Listen, it depends on who
you're
talking to.
That's why I filed my police report
Sister
on him
Noble.
On December 20th.
Sister Noble, hi.
Yes.
Hi,
yes.
I'm here.
Okay.
I want to say to you, it depends on who you're talking to. See,
okay.
Me, I don't have an extensive background of your situation.
Okay.
So if you say a thing, right? You're saying a thing right now, and I'm coming from a very objective perspective, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you say a thing, then it will probably prompt me to ask you a question.
Okay.
And so this is just us having a conversation, period. And I'm following per what you say. So if you say a thing and it gives me an idea or a thought, then I'm going to ask you the question.
All right.
And so you have to come with me. You have to come from the space that I don't have a very extensive knowledge.
Okay. I mean,
situation.
I thought you was in their chat room when the shit was going down. I really assumed
no,
you was in the chat room.
I was
listening.
Not. I don't believe so.
I don't believe so.
But if I did come in, I probably was surfing around and stuff.
Well, JM,
but I don't
was
really
there.
Know. I'm
JM
trying to tell
there.
You.
Yeah.
Who was?
JM, she was there in the chat room listening to everything that go down, that everything that went down.
She was in there?
Yeah, she was in there the whole time. She heard everything.
Okay, so now I'm a little bit confused about
go ahead.
I'm confused about the situation in this way. It's what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
I probably wouldn't even need to know all the background about a thing, not this particular thing.
Okay.
Other than to say, because the question is very specific, right?
Mm-hmm.
The question is that if you're saying that, and you have said that this person has been egregious towards you, right?
Yes.
has done some ill towards you,
mm-hmm.
why would you want to communicate with them? That's
you know
a
simple
question.
And that is a good question. And I'm going to tell you, you know, I'm not trying to sit up here and justify, you mm-hmm. know, anything to you. I'm not trying to, you know, make it seem like, you know, we dating again. I'm talking about me and this other person. I ain't trying to make it seem like we're dating again because we're not. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
I need people to understand that this man has called me multiple times to, you know, today. Okay.
Well,
he's not gonna stop chasing me.
You can block his number. Can't
I don't want to. I don't want to lose none of them text messages. I need all of them.
Oh,
when you block somebody, you lose all their text messages. So, you know, with that being said, yeah, I need all them text messages. When you block somebody, you lose them. Okay. So, with that being said, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I lose them once I block a person. You know, it's over. Okay.
Okay.
I have an Android.
Okay.
So, you know, with that being said, I don't have to make up nothing. I'm just telling you, I don't see them text messages no more after I block somebody for some odd reason. I just don't see them no more.
Making up anything.
What
I'm trying to figure out where it's going.
I want to explain to you. I understand what you're saying. Why are you talking to him? But when, you know, you have filed a police report on him, and I did not drop my case, by the way. He wanted me to drop my case, but I did not. So with that being said, I understand where you're coming from. Why are you still in communication with him? Why you haven't blocked him? I want to keep his text messages. No. I am not dating him. We're not dating. I don't want to date him. I just told him earlier, I'm not attracted to you at all. Okay. And I just told him that earlier. I'm not attracted to you.
You told him that today?
Yes, ma'am.
So you responded to the text
he's
messages?
He's calling. Yes, ma'am. Yes, I responded to him. I responded to him. Okay. Let me finish. So, you know, I told him today, let me finish. I told him I'm not attracted to him at all.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but guess what? This is a game to him. He's that type of person. This is a game to him. The chase is a game, because the more I tell this person to leave me alone, the more he's going to pursue me. This is a game to him.
Do you think if he just didn't say anything at all that he would stop?
You know what? Okay, I'll stop talking to him if that is. You know, I understand if that is.
No,
you know,
I'm asking you.
If that is going to help,
it's a question.
If that is going to help,
this is a question. Listen to me. I'm not saying I didn't bring.
If that's
going to
help, I'll stop talking.
I didn't bring a statement. I brought a question. The question is, do you think if you don't respond at all, would he stop?
No.
Do you believe if you didn't respond at all, he would stop?
No,
see, that's
ma'am.
A question.
No, ma'am.
So you think he would continue even if you didn't respond?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. See?
Yes, ma'am.
So do you think there's any kind of way that you can get some peace in a situation such as that first of all, do you want the communication to stop? I guess that's the better question.
I do. Yes. It's getting out of hand, and it's been out of hand, to be honest with you. It's been out of hand, and it's ridiculous. Because I already know what it is. I know what I'm dealing with here.
So you...
I know people are thinking, well, damn, you know, she done filed a case on him and, you know, she's still communicating. And he knows I have my case still open against him, by the way. He knows that. Like I said, he tried to get me to close my case. He tried to get me to close my case. Okay? But I'm not closing my case.
Okay,
So
I'm still, I think the question really probably has, well, maybe you did answer. So the answer to the question is the reason why you communicate with Black Sun is because you just don't know why you do. You just do it because you're not certain why.
Girl, you know? I do it because it's what I've been doing. It's what I've been doing.
It's just like
even
habit.
Though I cut him off. I cut him off back in November 2021. I cut him off.
So
why didn't
you just stay that course? Like why
ma'am,
you just didn't continue
he went on
that
smear
course?
Campaign against me on December 3rd, beginning on this other person's channel. He went on a smear campaign on December 3rd, talking about I had a sex tape. Me and him had a sex tape from 2013. And I had to defend myself. And also a lot of y'all don't know the backstory of when he first went on a smear campaign against me on October 25th of 2021. And he, you know, said some pretty ugly things about me, my church, my pastor. He said some things about my mother, who was deceased. A lot of y'all don't know that he began a smear campaign against me as early as October 25th. And I cut him off on November 10 after I saw that video in its entirety. That video that he did collaborating with the mental patient, I'll just call him the mental patient. The video he did collaborating with him on October 25th, I first saw in its full entirety on November 10.
You and know that, what?
That's I when think I cut
I
him
know
off.
What you're talking about.
I cut him off.
And yeah. I think I know who mm-hmm. you're referencing. Okay. Yes, now, mm-hmm. all right.
And also he went on another smear campaign on this other person's channel on December 3rd.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So
because I cut him off, I rejected him.
The reason
him.
Why you started back communicating was mm-hmm. because he did that. And so now you felt you needed to go out and, well, my thing is that why talk to him?
No, no, no. Did I say I started back communicating with him in December? No, ma'am, not December.
So after he did
I
all
started
that,
communicating with him because of the JM situation.
Wait,
I, did I say, said did I tell minutes, you that I did a conference call? Did no, I thought I told you I did a conference call with me and Aaliyah and him after Suave, after, you know, she went on Suave and told people
yeah,
that he sexually assaulted her. I think
minute,
I did a conference. Yes, I did. Tell you
yeah,
that I did
to,
a conference
we
call.
We need to back up for half a second.
I did do a conference call.
Like, I need to jump yeah. in a DeLorean.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
go back to the future. Okay. So we're going to jump in this DeLorean and we're going to yeah. go back to the future about
okay.
like two,
all
three
right.
seconds, right?
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
a minute. And so what I want to say is that you just said that after the first time I stopped talking to him.
Yeah,
so
I told you I cut him off on November 10.
Just listen to what I'm saying. So it implies that there was two times, yeah. right, that you stopped talking to him, at least
yes,
minimum.
Ma'am. Yeah.
So I'm saying that after he did the smear campaign
mm-hmm.
with
yep.
that particular individual,
yep.
and you
again,
talked to him,
on
you
December
talked
3rd.
To him again after that, mm-hmm. did you not?
On December 3rd, and he did another smear campaign
right. so
on
what
December
I'm saying
10th,
is that why
and
did you
I spoke
to
him in a conference call after the JM situation.
Okay, so I still want to say to you this:
mm-hmm.
why do you need to have a conversation with him? When you could have simply, if you want to address him about stuff, you could have just went live about it, right?
Yeah.
Or not say nothing at all.
Yeah.
Deal with the police. Department.
I didn't want to go live about that JM situation. I didn't know enough about that.
No.
I didn't know
well,
enough about
let's
it.
Take the JM
time.
Situation off the table.
Yeah.
Let's talk about because it's not about the JM situation.
Are you saying going live about the situation when he went on a smear campaign and on December 3rd?
If you're gonna, if you're trying to address,
because
what,
I did
what,
go on, I did go live about. That.
Okay, so then, but why did you
multiple like, times?
Why did you look? Listen to what I'm saying. Why did you engage in a one-on-one communication with him via text, phone? I don't even facsimile. I don't know what, however, through pigeons, call.
Mm-hmm.
Any kind of way, birds.
Yeah.
Why though?
The only are you talking about recently? Are you talking about recently after the Just Me situation?
Any
I'm
of the
sorry,
times
JM that, situation.
Any of the times that you did it.
Okay.
Any of the times.
I'm gonna go back over this again.
No, you don't have to.
Okay.
I'm asking you a simple question. I don't think you
I'm
get
gonna,
the question.
Yeah, I'm trying to answer
you,
your question. Let me answer
any
your
of
question.
The times that you decided that you wanted to
question.
Re-engage in communication with
Let
him.
Me answer your question, ma'am. Please.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm just saying, don't go back.
Okay.
I get it.
Because nobody came to my defense when them niggas went on a smear campaign against me late last year. Nobody came to my defense. Nobody came to Aaliyah's defense. Okay. Nobody. When we first told everybody what was going on, because I went on my channel, me and Aaliyah both went on my channel and addressed them for their smear campaign. None of y'all supported us. Nobody. Okay. Nobody. In fact, y'all thought that I was not credible when I told you all about this nigga.
No, I said why?
He got a sex tape
why
on me,
did you
and
communicate
I said,
with him personally?
I never did a sex tape with this nigga.
But my
That's
question still would be why did you communicate with him personally?
Okay.
Like my question won't change. It will be the same.
Yeah.
Why did you communicate with him anytime after the time that you stopped communicating with him? I don't care if it was once.
You know what? That's a damn good question. That's a damn good question.
Yeah,
like I told you earlier.
Can we answer it?
And guess what? I don't want to be with that nigga. I don't want nobody to think that I want to date him. I need y'all to understand that.
But you didn't answer the question.
I think that's what you're getting at.
You know, that's not what I'm getting at.
But I don't want to date him.
No. That is not where I'm getting at. What I'm getting at. I asked you a question, right? This is a simple question.
I don't want to be
why. This is a simple question, and the question will still remain the same. I'm asking you, why engage or have communication with him one-on-one in any kind of form, whether it be text or phone call, after?
You know what? Because didn't I tell you that he keeps calling me and I keep answering the damn phone like an idiot? Didn't I tell you that?
So you don't have any answer to that? Like,
I told you that.
You just don't know why.
I just keep answering the phone like an idiot.
You just don't know why.
But Aaliyah told me, girl, you need to cut off all communication with him. In fact, I did cut off all communication with him. And then this JM situation broke, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I got, you know, back in communication with him. And you can ask Aaliyah that. She'll confirm it.
No, I believe you. That's the point.
I think we did a three-way conference call. Me, him, and her.
I think you're misunderstanding where I'm coming from, right? So that's why I keep telling you to calm down.
Yeah.
What I'm saying to you is this, right? And I'm getting, because I want to hear what you're saying, right? And I understand you fully. So if I'm asking you a question, it's only because I'm trying to get a full understanding. And it's not to make you feel uncomfortable, nor to throw an accusation or any of those things, because that's not what is happening here.
Okay.
I'm simply, if you notice,
all I'm doing is
asking you questions, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm asking you the question. And you're simply saying to me, I think.
Why do I keep answering my phone? Yeah.
No, you're simply saying to me, I think at this point is that you really just don't know why. And that you also know you need to stop.
I need to stop. Yes.
That's what I get from it.
I need to stop. Yeah.
So now that's your realization, right? And I think it's a good one. Like, I'm not, I think it's a good course of action.
Yeah, I need
to
stop. Yeah.
So how do you think you'll go about it? Like, what do you think you can do?
I guess block his number, but I'll lose all the texts. I'll lose his text message. I need him, okay? But I'll lose him if I block his number. But he's going to reach out in other ways. Like, you know, well, I already got him blocked on my emails. I got him
blocked
there.
I got him blocked
in the emails already. He's not going to
stop.
Can
you download the texts? Like, can you download them?
Yeah, I can take screenshots. Ma'am, I will block this motherfucking number right now, okay? I will block it. You know, right here, right now. Okay, hold on. I will block it right now. Okay, hold on.
Well, I mean, you know.
No, I block it right now. I'm gonna block it. Hold on. I'm doing something. I'm finna do it. Okay, hold on. Yeah, I got it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yes, a bit.
It can be taken that way. I need to block it. I do.
You're saying he's harassing you, or do you feel like he's harassing you?
No, he's not harassing me, but he is very, very persistent. He's not harassing me. He's very persistent. I'm gonna need y'all to understand. I'm not afraid of this. I'm not afraid of him. I need y'all to understand that.
Well, okay.
Okay, but let me tell you, I need y'all to understand that I'm not afraid of him. But
I'm gonna block him.
Ma'am,
he's not harassing me.
Okay, he is calling me though. He's very persistent, but he's not harassing me.
Please calm down.
Okay.
Because we're going to have, let's engage in a conversation.
Okay.
So I got to hear you and you got to hear me, right? So we're talking.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's nothing to be kind of uptight about or anything like that.
Yeah.
So you're not scared of him, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's not harassing you. He's more like persistent.
Yeah.
But he's done these things where you had to file a report on him. Right.
No, ma'am. I filed a report on him for the allegation of a sex tape he claimed that he has on me from 2013.
Report on him, right?
Okay. Yeah, that's it.
Okay, so nothing. Well, I'm gonna say that is, if somebody is taking pictures of you, that's not right, right? Unbeknownst to you.
Yeah, it's a felony in the state of Georgia.
Right. Yeah. So with all that going on, like, if he's constantly communicating with you, why don't you just file a report about the communication and say, look, this is happening, or get some kind of restraining order in regards to that or what have you. Like, why haven't you dealt with that aspect of it so that you don't have to have these calls anymore?
I forwarded his text messages to the detective.
Oh, Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have the email. I have his email. I'm talking about the detective's email.
So you've done all that. So really there's no need for any other communication because you've done your due diligence in regards to your situation, right?
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Hold on for a minute. I'm screenshotting the text messages so I can block his number. Okay.
Yeah. Because like if somebody's doing a thing to you that you don't like, then you should be able to speak to that and eliminate it out of your life. Like if people are doing things to me that I don't like, what I do is just, you know, distance myself from them. Okay, from that situation so I can have peace, because it's about having peace, right? And peace of mind.
Yes, I got it. I know what you're saying. And then I also want to say
mm-hmm. I'm really not quite understanding why you would allow him up on your panel to clear his name, mm-hmm. but you did that, right? I mm-hmm. would say that if a person is if a person is not engaging with you the way you want them to engage with you, mm-hmm. maybe it's best for you not to allow them to clear up anything. Unless they're, you know what I mean? Like, I'm trying to figure out, like, why would you be concerned about him clearing his name? What does that do for you?
Okay.
What does that do
for ma'am, you? Ma'am, they said that, he sexually assaulted me.
Wait, what? What do you say?
You didn't hear that?
No, I'm asking you to repeat yourself.
They said that he sexually assaulted me.
And so what I'm saying, you know, you said that he didn't, right? And you have a knowledge that he didn't,
you
right?
He did not.
Okay, so but
they said that he raped me. He
could clear his name on his own page.
Yeah.
Why did you feel like you needed to go and assist a person that gets on your nerves so damn much and has been persistently bothering you? And you don't, and has taken pictures of you allegedly, but didn't, right? So why would you go out of your way?
I still think he recorded me. Video.
Okay, recorded you.
I think he did that. Still.
You still think he did? Oh, you think he did?
Yeah. And I reported it to the proper authorities.
But you don't have any proof of it.
I don't have the video.
Okay, but what I'm saying, still, after even with all that being said, I'm saying that it doesn't seem like he would be your friend, that he's actually would be more so like your enemy or something like that. And I don't understand why you were going out of your way to
Ma'am, I know he's not my friend.
So why did you need to help him clear his name?
You know what? I wanted him not only to clear his name, but I also wanted him to clear up the misconceptions and the lies that were told on me earlier on another panel that day.
I still don't see why you needed to engage with him. There was no need for a communication, is all I'm saying.
I understand. There's no need for communication. You're right.
I mean, that's all I'm saying. There was no need for you to, you know, one-on-one communicate with him. I mean, there's so many ways, like, many ways to skin a cat. You know what I mean?
Okay, yeah, I understand. I get it.
There's so many different ways to skin a cat.
I
think that, you know,
I'm still screenshotting his text messages so I can block him.
Okay. So look, I think that if you're trying to be of a help to somebody, then you probably can be of a help in a different way. I would not be trying to help out a person who did egregious things towards me or did an egregious thing. Like, let them be and do them. Now, I can see maybe if you were trying to somehow help out JM or something like that. That would be different because you have a case and you have your story, right?
I don't think you, you heard me earlier when I said that they said he sexually assaulted me and I had to come out on this other person's channel on March 19th and tell them that Black Sun never sexually assaulted me.
Yeah, that's so how why did you have to
I
talk
was
to
brought
him?
Back into the fray.
But why did you have to go have a conversation with him? BS.
Okay. I got you.
That part makes no sense, right?
Well, you know, you're gonna have to ask Aaliyah that, because you know, Aaliyah and I, we all did a conference call. You're the only one
that could answer that question.
You know, so
like you're the only one because it's your action, right?
Yeah.
Aaliyah is not your brain and she's not your action. You are the only one that can answer that.
But you're gonna have to ask her because I don't know. She reached out to him and then that's how I got back into talking to him. So you're gonna have to ask her that.
Well, Aaliyah seems like a good sister to you, like a friend. So I don't see her just like reaching out to somebody who has done something egregious to you. To what end?
But she did. You know, she reached out to him, you know, and said, you know, see, they done set you up. And he returned her call.
So now so if we're talking about a setup, right?
Mm-hmm.
Of any sorts, then your situation could be implied as a setup too.
Setup with the video cameras and stuff. Yeah. Yeah.
No, I'm saying all of this whole thing can be implied as a setup. So I don't understand why she would choose those particular words, but they were used because you've said it now twice, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So I don't know why she would use those words, but it implies something. And I don't think JM, like, were you not helping the sister, JM? Or being a support unto her?
Yeah. We spoke.
And so you're supportive of her, right?
But I'm not setting her up though.
No, I didn't say you were. What I'm saying mm-hmm. is that you believe her, correct?
Yeah.
And you're now, supportive of her, correct?
I do now. I believe her now. Yeah.
So at one point in time you didn't?
Mm-mm, no. I just told you that. This other person said that Black Sun sexually assaulted me. And I had to come back out on YouTube and tell them on her channel on March 19, by the way, I went up on her panel and told her and the rest of them that Black Sun never sexually assaulted me and Black Sun never raped me.
So are you saying, let me be clear, are you saying that JM made that statement?
No. Okay. This other person. Okay, said that Black Sun sexually assaulted me and whatever. And I went up on her panel and told her that Black Sun never sexually assaulted me. Black Sun never raped me.
Mm-hmm.
This was on March 19th.
Mm-hmm. So let me ask you this question. If JM didn't say it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then what is the point of it? Like,
JM did say it. My bad. JM said it, but it was this other person who led her to believe that Black Sun sexually assaulted me. JM did say it. She did say it. She said it right on Suave Channel on March 18th.
So you're saying that JM said that and that mm-hmm. made you what? Not believe that that happened to her?
Okay. I heard it on March 19th. Okay. I first heard it on March 19th, spoken on this other person's channel. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I heard this other person talking about Black Sun sexually assaulted me. I went up on her panel on March mm-hmm. 19th. It was on a Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
And I told everybody that Black Sun never sexually assaulted me. Black Sun never raped me. I don't regret doing that. I don't regret mm-hmm. doing that at all. So I did not believe that Just Me's story was credible based on her affiliation with that camp. That's all.
I did not believe
her story to be credible.
Just based on who she's affiliated with?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Just like she said she did not believe my story to be credible, I did not believe her story to be credible either at first.
So you're saying that...
At first.
You're saying that she said mm-hmm. that she didn't believe that you were telling the truth about a thing.
Exactly. That's what she
said. And so...
She said it on Suave's channel, by the way.
So therefore, in return,
No, not in retaliation. Let's get this straight. Not out of retaliation. Oh no, I'm not gonna let you put that on me.
Well, I'm not trying to put because anything on you. I did not believe her
because she didn't believe me at first. No, ma'am.
This is not about retaliation. No, you didn't believe her because of the camp.
Believe her story to be credible because of her affiliation with that woman. That's why. Because of that woman lying, telling people that Black Son sexually assaulted me, I did not believe her, I'm talking about JM's story, to be credible. Because of that lie that they put out on me. Talking about Black Son sexually assaulted me. Calm down.
So,
ma'am, don't tell me to calm down. I'm very irritated right now because y'all didn't defend me. Y'all did not defend me when me and Aaliyah was going through with that woman over there when she was slandering us.
Y'all did not defend me.
Y'all did not come out in defense of me.
Who's y'all?
All of y'all. All of y'all that sat back and listened and heard what that woman was saying about Aaliyah and me.
Yeah.
Nobody came out in defense of us.
I think that you have to understand, right, that this is a very big place, right, YouTube? Everybody is not aware of all the situations mm-hmm. that go on with people. And I will be one of those people.
You're right.
So I think the word y'all is too open of a word.
You're right.
So I want to get back to an understanding, right?
I just want to make sure that nobody puts out a false narrative about me talking about, because it's, you know, obviously nobody's putting out a false narrative. It's not about a retaliation.
I need to get this very clear. I am not saying it's a retaliation. I'm asking you questions. If you say it's not a retaliation, I believe you. I want to get past that, please. And I need you to calm down because I don't want to elevate my voice. It's strenuous. Okay. Okay. And I don't want to start sounding like a man.
Okay.
Because I'm a lady.
Okay. So I'm an aggressive person by nature.
Let's bring our voices down.
I'm an aggressive person by nature anyway.
You should not be. You don't have to be.
No, ma'am, I have to be. In this environment, I have to be aggressive.
We don't know each other.
I'm talking about these YouTube streets. We don't know each other that well.
And I have not showed you any aggression.
I have to be very aggressive.
Oh, Lord. We have not known each other very well.
Go ahead.
We have not known each other very long, mm-hmm. right?
I know.
We don't know each other very well, mm-hmm. and I'm not showing you aggression.
Okay, so please return
what I'm giving to you.
Okay.
That's all I'm asking.
Okay, got it. Respectability. I got it. Respect of each other. I got it.
Well, I don't know, because I was going to ask you some more questions, but I think I want to say one more thing. Look.
Okay.
JM has an association with a woman that you don't trust, right? And you say in that particular platform, she went along with that platform as to say that she doesn't believe in what you were bringing forth.
Yes, ma'am.
So when the time came, right, something happened to her with this particular person that you had an issue with, right? The same guy. You didn't believe her because of the camp that she's coming out of. So
yes, ma'am.
You're saying that camp is a known camp that tells stories or something, and that you feel like that JM would be, she would tell a story. So she would just make up a story. She would just make up a story of her being violated.
I didn't say she would just make up a story of her being violated, but I will say this. Because of the lie that was put out by that camp, talking about Black Son sexually assaulted me, I did not believe JM to be credible at the time. I did not believe her to be credible at that time.
Okay, but we take away the camp and the people.
Mm-hmm.
Then what else would cause you not to believe that she was credible?
Now, if she was by herself, if she was some stranger coming on YouTube and saying this, and she had not heard my story, if she had not heard what they did to me, heard all the slander and you know, lies that were told about me and Aaliyah, then, you know, more than likely I would not have formed an opinion on her story not being credible. Okay. More than likely.
But know? now you believe her.
I mean, yeah, I do now.
Okay. And you know so because you do have a copy of her police report.
Well, I know so not only because I have a copy of her police report, but also because of, you know, him not being able to answer the questions on my channel on April 19.
Right, when Taz was there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, this is interesting. This is what I want to say, because I have to move forward. I've dedicated yes. so much time to the yeah. situation, and I have to move forward. But what I want to say to you is this, is that if there is a time in your life where somebody is not treating you well, and they show a pattern of that, like, you know, it's a repetitiveness, I think it would always be in your best interest to, you know, sever ties or remove yourself from that relationship, because it's toxic, uh-huh. right? It's uh-huh. a toxic environment, yeah. a toxic relationship.
Yes, it
and
is.
We don't need those type of things, you know what I'm saying? Especially uh-huh. as Black women, we, you know, we have enough in our life, right, to deal with, and we uh-huh. don't need to be dealing with toxic relationships. And it's not good for your face, you know what I'm saying?
Ma'am,
wrinkles and
ma'am,
all that kind of stuff.
I hear what you're saying. I got this. Trust me, I got this. I don't need no coaching. I don't need anybody to tell me
okay.
what I need to do or not do. I got
I'm not
this,
trying to
okay?
coach you. I'm just saying. I'm trying to elevate the spirit a little
this.
Bit.
I got
I'm definitely not trying
you
know. To coach you.
But you, but you understand. You. Can you understand what I've been through, though? Can you understand the shit I've gone through, me and Aaliyah? Can you understand?
That's what I'm saying. Understand
do you
that.
Get it?
No, I get it. But I think,
okay.
I think the
right.
problem here, right, the problem here in this situation is that mm-hmm. we came up here to deal with one specific part of the situation, not
yes.
to tackle all the parts of it. And the mm-hmm. specific part that we're talking about today is, why do you continue to engage with him, and, you know, back
okay.
and forth?
And
the reason why,
block him.
Can I finish?
Yes.
The reason why we're talking about that is because we all know that there has been allegations, right, by mm-hmm. you, things that were said back and forth. And so that's mm-hmm. why this conversation, this particular conversation about this question
yes.
is of importance. And that's all
yes.
we're going to be talking about. Like, I wasn't trying to go into other arenas. It's too vast, right? And
mm-hmm.
truth is not none of my business, but I obliged because you asked me, could we have this conversation? Because you wanted to clear up some things.
Yes,
and I
is.
Think you have. I think, you know, it got a little rough, a little rocky. Right?
Yeah,
but
because yeah, because I had
story.
To make sure that you understand, you know, where I'm coming from, because it don't make sense. It don't make sense that I'm still talking to him. You're right. It doesn't. And I admit that. I'm not up here trying to justify anything. I admit that it you know, I shouldn't be talking to him, because he has said some pretty ugly things about me, my church, my pastor, Aaliyah. He has said some very ugly things about us. And, you know, he has went on a smear campaign. He went on a smear campaign against me and Aaliyah late last year. So, you know, but, you know, it really began with me and Aaliyah on October 25th. But, you know, it continued. It just, you know, progressed.
Yeah. No, I understand. Like, I think Sister Aaliyah thinks
yeah.
I don't understand your
mm-hmm.
sentiment, and I,
mm-hmm.
but I do. But also, I'm gonna say this:
mm-hmm.
there's so many moving parts, right?
Yeah.
And so
yeah.
I want to be very specific as to this moving part, because this is your opportunity to say, like, hey, I know that, you know, probably me talking to him probably doesn't look good, but
mm-hmm.
this is why. And I think we got that understanding.
Yeah, yeah.
And so you have done something very proactive in this moment. You have blocked him, right?
I'm actually screenshotting all his texts.
Right.
Before,
so you're being proactive. And
yeah,
so that is
yeah.
all we, you know, one could ask of you, if they were going to mm-hmm. ask anything of you.
I mean, because Aaliyah been told me, you know, to stop talking to him. She been told me, but, you know, I did not block him. Okay,
yeah.
that's the reason, you know.
And again, I would say this,
yeah.
right? A bit tired.
Yeah.
Yes, we already went through that part of
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
She says no, not really though. It still doesn't make sense that you would give a predator to your platform to clear his name unless you're trying to set him up. I'm just saying, that's what she's saying, right?
Yeah.
I'm good today. I'm good today, Gary. Good day. No, that's my Cali brother. What I'm saying is that, and
I mean,
I
he
get
set
where a good
himself
tide,
up.
I
He set
get
himself
where a
up.
good tide is coming from, as to say
You
that.
heard what I said. He set himself up.
Okay, but I'm just saying, it's your platform, right? You can do with it as you will. Me personally, like if somebody is much, like really egregious, have done some really foul stuff, I definitely wouldn't let them up on my platform because for me, I think that would be triggering, right? But everybody handles situations differently. I think that maybe, I don't know if it's because of a religious aspect or what have you, that you felt inclined to
No.
be helpful. I don't
This
know.
ain't got nothing to do with my religious upbringing.
Okay, well then I don't know. I couldn't tell you.
You heard what I said
But
earlier, right? He set himself up.
okay, well then it's to be continued.
He set
Then
himself
it's
up.
to be continued. All right. Thank
You
you, Sister
understand?
Noble. I have to
Okay.
really, move forward because I only allocated myself so much time. But I do appreciate you coming up here and speaking to your experience. And I hope that you will forever come back to Highlander Country.
I will. I mean, I just, I'm just glad that you didn't drop me off the panel,
Why would I
No,
drop you off the panel?
I'm just saying, because I am aggressive. I'm an aggressive person.
No, I mean
I just
that's
feel
rude,
like
and I'm
people.
not a rude person,
No,
and nor am
aggressive.
I a person
That's
to.
not rude. Aggressive is n not
Well, either
necessarily rude,
way,
but that's okay.
rude.
That's
I'm
okay.
not rude nor aggressive or none of the things, and I will always give you a space to speak, right? And I give people space to speak, and everything is within reason. I'm not one to drop people off the panel. I unfortunately I have not. Let me see. I think so far that hasn't happened yet. But I started off saying that I wouldn't drop people from the panel and I wouldn't block them in the chat. But the blocking the chat part went south. But I am, good in the game for the dropping
Does
people off the
anyone have
panel
any
part.
questions in the chat room before we go? Because I don't want to leave out anything if people are
Well, the only
if people
question
are
I can see
wondering.
here is that a bit tired is asking, wait, how did he set himself up? But I, I think there's going to be more, and I'm trying to move forward, brethren. Okay, thank you. I love y'all, but the sister has so much time allocated to the situation, and it has to just be a to be continued. Can we go forward, brethren? Can a church say amen? Highlander Country, can you get aboard with that and let's move forward? Man, but let me see. See, I see, girl. Okay, she's so crazy. Anyways, all right. I'm gonna let you down, and I
All
appreciate your
right.
time. And look, I support however you move.
Okay. All right.
Okay, thank
Thank you.
you.
All
Bye.
right. You have a good day. Bye-bye.
You too. All right, everybody. Let me see. Let's see. Okay, we're back, right? Oh my goodness. That was interesting. So Sister Noble came and she cleared up some things, and I think everybody has an understanding. And so now we can move forward. And this is my first interview. I don't know if it went that well, but it was, you learn. You know what I'm saying? Baby steps. You learn and you keep moving and then you get better with it, right? So that would be my first interview in Highlander Country. Man, that was exciting. That was interesting. Let me go ahead and let me see. 1 second. 1 second. I think it's some people I haven't said hi to that came in here. Let me see. Investing out of the blue. Hello, brother. Nice to see you. Big O came in the chat. What's up, Big O? And let me see. Oh, Tinfoil Media. Meta Media. He keeps changing his name. Like, my goodness. I'm like, what in the hell's going on? And then, of course, Sister Aaliyah Muhammad was in the chat. So I want to talk about some interesting things that happen with the Nature Boy camp. Woo-hoo, that boy Solar, and I think his name is Musa. They have left the building. Oh, these niggas miraculously decided to just up and go, and they are Mexico. I mean, content creators have been running this conversation. I mean, I tell you, the last 24 hours has been very, very strong. Thanks for being patient, Noble. Appreciate your time. Exactly. I got to get better with interviewing. But I hope the good Sister Noble knows that I wasn't trying to be, you know, like talking over or anything like that. Because I don't, you know, I want to hear people and I want them to hear me. So I hope she understands that. And my next interview will be better. I gotta get my chops in this game when it comes to that. But oh, so back to what I was saying. So they're in Mexico. I'm like, in Mexico? Now, there's a couple of narratives running with that. One is that they left to Mexico to set up a situation for Nature Boy. And then the second one, I think, is they went to Mexico to set up their own situation. And then the third narrative is that they're on the run because they know that this is going to be like Rico on their asses. Everybody going to go down. It's going to be like a Rico conspiring, participating, all the things that happened in the Rico situation. And I think they said, fuck it. I'm going to get to Mexico where you can't lock my black ass up. So the solar guy, he changed his name to Something Love. Is it Something Love? What is his new name? Well, he has a whole new name. These niggas stay changing their name. Now, I know they ain't doing it legally. I mean, doing it legally, because if they would have their ass down at the Social Security Department where you have to go to change your name 24/7, like, they'd be like, But they're going to, well, they have changed their name again, except for Musa. I don't think Musa. But anyways, was it King World or New World? What is his name? World News TV. I was in this chat a little bit last night because I had went to bed early and then I woke up. And was it last night? I think it was last night. I was on one of those things, but they had called. Solar and that Musa guy literally had called one of those platforms. And the guy who was interviewing him, or actually trying to get all the questions out of him, was doing a great job. he was getting all kinds of information. And I guess they want to go and, like, they're still pushing the three, but they're trying to get to know themselves and build, you know, the Solar, aka whatever the hell he is now, wants to be like a teacher, and he's going to teach the three and learn from within and I guess, you know, become a better person. And I don't really know all these stories because I think I mentioned the situation about Zoka and her child, because Zoka and him had a child together, but I didn't know that baby had died. I'm like, what? I was aware of Nature Boy, but I just thought he was some clown out there putting on a show, right? And this is going back some time, so I never really, really paid him no attention. And then the rumblings come up and you start hearing little things, but there's people that go back, right? They really, really go back. About like 4 and some 7 years. I don't know how long has he been doing this for 7 years. I mean, they've been putting some effort in. Mexico expedites to America. Oh, well, then they in the wrong place to be real. I know they don't expedite in Spain. Hey, Michael Phillips, what's going on? Man, did you see that they are running all these narratives? With Nature Boy and the two Negroes that then ran off. You were speaking about that the other day. I'm like, what? So Mexico doesn't expedite. Spain expedites, I know. They should have. Do they not know where they're at? Do they not understand? They can still disappear in the jungle, though. The facts. And they know them jungles, because wasn't they rolling around in them jungles for a minute? I mean, hanging from, let me not say that. I was just gonna say some shit that would not sound right. But them niggas, they was in the jungle. And, you know, hiking and stuff and finding little waterfalls with caves behind it and shit. Like, they. So, Sirsaida, did you ever find out what happened to the premature baby that was with Nature Boy? I think that's the Zoka, but Zoka's baby. And then that baby died. Because I remember her saying something like the baby was 6 pounds and so many ounces. And that's considered premature. So I'm thinking that's the situation. Hold up, Nature Boy is out of jail. No, he's not out of jail. Did they let that nigga out of jail? Gary, don't have me over here. No, he ain't out of jail. He don't have a court date until the 6th. The heck are you talking about? Don't get me confused, Gary. Don't get a sister confused about this Negro. He don't have a court date until the 6th with the Superior Court, but people have been running those narratives. A lot of people have been running that narrative. They've been sitting out there talking about he's out of jail. Now, I've been on Big O. And, hey, Sister Leah, peace. And Gary Hawkins, his bond hearing is 5-6, right? They're not letting him out sooner than that. I didn't think so. What else did I want to say about his eyes? Because he's seen a Superior Court judge for the bond hearing. The first person he saw, I believe, was the magistrate. And she was not going to let him go, OR him or anything to that nature, or set a bond. She just moved it right on up the ladder. Go over there and deal with it. And the irony of it was a white woman. A white woman did that to his ass. Call that, you know, he be talking a lot of shit. Anyways, Nature Boy. For all of them black judges out there, he ended up getting a white woman judge. But somebody was saying the other day that Nature Boy thinks he's a white woman. That Nature Boy is a white woman. I said, what? He was all in them chats saying all kinds of crazy stuff. I say, something to ponder. He might, you know, definitely think he thinks he's a woman. You know what I'm saying? A white one? I don't know. Maybe he thought he was a white woman at one point in time because his ass was getting away with bloody murder and nobody was locking him up. But I definitely think he knows he's a black woman now, if he's going to be a woman. You a black woman. Man. And he's really sick with it. But they're fleeing the ship. Now, I haven't been on Big O today, and I haven't really been paying attention because I've been busy. But I wonder if, what news is out there about this situation? Has anything came up about the rest of them? What's the girl's name? Malia. Malia's there. Zoka's there. I don't know all their names. Are they sticking around? Are they still in that house? Didn't they get an eviction? Where are they going to go? Did Solar really just go out there to set up a camp for them? Or is he severing ties? Because I know that true dude that didn't turn himself into Ace. What's up, Misunderstood? Peace in the LBC. True, he is on Big O yawning with bags underneath his eyes, talking about, what did he say? What was it? Playing videos on quantum theory and shit like that, weird stuff. You know what I mean? And dropping people like hot potatoes. I try to get my black ass up there to tell this, you know, nigga, why the hell, you know what I'm saying? Got my questions or what have you. And he dropped me so quick, I was like, ooh, faster than a 1959 transistor radio. He just turned it off. He was dropping so many people. It was ridiculous, right? So, you know, so he hanging in there. He's hanging in there. I think he thinks that he's going to die on that hill. I think he thinks that he is him and Nature Boy are one. And they probably were one, you know, and, you know, twined as one, twined. Because I think, and I've been saying this, those are his wives and his husbands. You know what I'm saying? They all got it from him. Now, more than others, because he seems to have favorites, right? He seems to have, you know, those that he wants to be, you know, he has a more of attraction with. Because that Malia girl, this is the thing. I posed this question. I wonder if they can get him for gang stalking. Now, look, just follow me down this rabbit hole. or not him, or per se the girls, right? If they're like doing like a RICO thing, could they get him and the girls for gang stalking? Because that one time when that Malia girl left the house, they followed her all the way up to the top, you know, the thoroughway, the top of the block, right? Where the car, you can see the cars come down. So they went off the block, off the cul-de-sac, out of the neighborhood, onto the main street. And they were following her. And so she sits down finally, like on this, like cylinder type wall, not brick, but like, you know, when you have those cylinders stacked on top of each other type of thing. I felt like that's what it was. Maybe it was a brick. Cemented. It was cemented wall. She sat there and they start like fussing with her, right? But they were fussing with her the whole time. Because when I think about it, when she was first coming up the block, they stopped. And that one girl, I don't know her name, but one of them bees took off on her. That was the first attack. Then they followed her some more all the way to the top. She sits down and they take off on her again. I think it was the same bee. They got to complaining, right? She says, oh, you get all the D. You get all the D. This one gives H and none of them get any D. I mean, I said, was that some repressed sexual frustration much? For some sick pain? Like, we know this dude got issues, that he's infested. It's like a petri dish. So you fussing over a sick pain. And you guys as a group are following this girl down the street, stopping every so, you know, every 5 minutes or every 3 minutes, I'm gonna say every 3 minutes, and mollywhopping her, okay? We talking street talk now. Yeah, boop, boop, boop. You know, giving her two pieces and stuff, right? What is that? Is that gang stalking? Are they not a gang? A whole bunch of broads following another woman and bing, bing, bing. And harassing her while she's walking down the street, then lumping her up again, bing, bing, bing. Can somebody tell me, is that considered gang stalking? I'm thinking, right? I'm just thinking, like, the charges that can come out. But then, you know, you have the affiliation and association and all that kind of stuff too, right? Because you guys have participated in all the wackadoodle things that Nature Boy has done. You have literally supported him when he was dancing with the little baby girl and he had an erection. You supported him when, you know, he told you to go mop up this girl, you know, sick two of you on one, like you guys are some pit bulls or something, Rockwilders. You participated in that. You got on live saying, hey, you know, he is God and everything he does is great. And you have defended him in his effery. Like you have defended his every action. So you cannot say, ladies, little girls, I'm gonna say little girls, you cannot say that you haven't been complicit, you know, a RICO type of thing. But they could put specific charges to him. But I do recall in that video, he was saying, just leave her alone. But they kept on going forth. But he didn't come out and follow them and say, hey, stop it. Do not do that. Because he had control over them, right? You know, he had them all lined up in formation, doing all the things, doing the robot, pop lock and dropping and all that stuff. A brand new dance called a Pee Wee Herman. Dun, 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 dun. You know what I'm saying? They was doing it. Or whatever the hell they were saying. So I'm saying he could have stopped it. So you are an orchestra of the gang stalking. Am I being too far-fetched? Could somebody let me know? Put a one in the chat if you think I'm just too far-fetched with this, right? And that, is there such a charge as gang stalking? That's a two-part question. Okay. Put them on the chat if you think I'm far-fetched. Put a two in the chat if you think I'm on point or like getting to a point, that something that's feasible, right? I'm trying to tell you, I feel like that was some, you know, gang-like activity going on. So one, if you disagree, and two, if you agree with me. Then I have another question. Like, I don't know. Maybe. Nah, man, you know. It's just weird. I just feel like the bullshit is, you know, the game is afoot, right? I tell you all the time, the game is afoot at all times. Oh, thank you, Melanated Agenda. You think I'm off? You think I'm far-fetched from the situation? Oh, crap. I think I was going somewhere with it. So would it be considered gang stalking? Is there such thing as gang stalking? Like a charge? That's another question. Let's look it up. Because I wonder if there's such thing as being charged with gang stalking. I think there is. Because I didn't pull that out of nowhere. Oh, you think I'm on point, misunderstood? I thank you. I appreciate you, sister, for participating in my one and my two. I'm trying to tell you, I think there is such thing as gang stalking, like gang stalking charges. This thing is so damn slow right now. Every time I want to find out some information, like Google just decides that it doesn't want to deal with me. The all-knowing Google. I used to know somebody used to say, ask my, you know, talk rough. Ask my B, Google. She know everything. Horrible, the shenanigans and the communication, but you know, Saida understands all the languages except for dog. I do not speak dog. You get to talking in dog, right? You know, I'm barking and shit and having all kinds of other things going on. And you know, I don't understand dog. Outside of to say this, you know, shut up, bitch. I could say that in dog, because you know, or human. And then the last word is dog, bitch. It's horrible. Let me see. Gang. Let me write this one. Gang. Oh, Lord. Stalking. And let me see. Charges. Gang stalking charges. I'm asking Google. I can't even get that out right. Gang stalking, mind control. What is gang stalking? What is the definition of gang? Interstate stalking. What is the goal of gang stalking? Large companies. I'm trying to see. I don't see anything that says there's a charge for it. Stalking and harassment, criminal defense. Oh, gang stalking legal definition, which makes it criminal offense to travel across state lines to stalk another person. That's going across state lines. Well, because some kind of stalking or something. You're alive this morning. Oh, okay. No. I know there's cyber stalking. Well, it's some kind of something going on, because I'm trying to tell you, when you have like six girls or seven girls, right? Boy, I know it's considered jumping, but I don't know if you can really say it was jumping, because only one of them was taken off on her. But I feel like they can make something out of that situation. That video, that footage, they can level something to somebody with that alone, because you see that she's clearly trying to go get away in that moment, right? And they are like harassing her, or, you know, going after her. And then all of a sudden, you know, they're fighting. But I wouldn't be fighting him, her. If you say that she's getting all the D and she's leaving, and you make a complaint, I mean, of all the things you could have said to speak to why she was leaving, you could have said all kinds of things like, girl, why are you leaving? You know, we're a family, da-da-da-da-da. No, you say you get all the D, she doesn't get none, and she gets head. I'm like, what? That made no sense. So I'm just saying, if you feel a way about not getting none, the one who's getting it, don't you want that person to leave? They're weird. That make no sense to me. As women, because they're not women, they're children. They're kids. In their mind, and their, you know, their mind has been taken over. They're zombie crabs. I think I told you guys about the zombie crab before, right? Where this parasite, this it's a parasite. Well, this thing goes inside the crab, right? And it takes over his whole skeletal system, takes over his whole body, like half of it at least, a good portion of it. And it causes the male crabs to think that they're female. And it pushes out a sac at the bottom of the male crab. And the male crab literally thinks it's a female and now starts like rubbing that sac and calling himself, you know, it's protecting the rest of those parasites that have got about to go out there. It goes in the female crab, and the female crab doesn't know she's coming or going. She's just basically infertile now and taking over. It's a trip. So I say they, you know, they some zombie crabs. Get into it. Gang stalking is illegal because each would be charged with stalking. So even though there is the term gang stalking, it's the stalking laws that would get them prosecuted. Thank you, misunderstood. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, because there was some stalking going down. But again, I'm telling you about the zombie crabs to let you know that, you know, look at the situation with them. The men think they're women or act or behave in that way. The girls don't know if they're coming or going. You know, they've been infected in their mind by this parasite that we're going to call Nature Boy. You know, this barnacle. It's a barnacle that goes inside of them. So, like, this thing. And it's taken over. So I don't think that, you know, Solar and Musa left, they're still pushing the three. They're trying to separate themselves in a way, but they're not denouncing Nature Boy. They're still, you know, dealing with his ideology and stuff like that. You know, they pushing the three. And that's what's really going on. So we're just going to have to see. We're just going to have to see where this story goes. But I'm going to get in the streets. I thank y'all for coming by here. Misunderstood, A Bit Tied, my brother Gary. Much love. Melanated Agenda. Man, Sister Noble, Michael Phillips. Sister Leah came through. Who was? Oh, New Era King was here. Out of the Blue came through. Out of the Blue Vestments. Yeah. I think it's called ODB. Out of the Blue. Yeah, ODB. Big O. Big O came through. And Tinfoil Meta Media. He has changed his name again. Like, what is going on? What is going on with that tinfoil? Anyways, I'm about to, you know, I don't know. You guys change your name so much on your little avatars and stuff. I just be like, man, I can't keep up. But anyways, as long as I can read, I can keep up, huh? Just read it and get into it. You know what I'm saying? And keep it pushing. But anyways, thank y'all for coming. I appreciate it. This was, you know, this is a good day for me. You know, I'm just a little bit tired because the other day I gave it live that was 5 hours. And I said, I just can't. I cannot do this no more. You're welcome. I asked my attorney to double check the law since I've dealt with stalking. Thank you. I'm talking about what a sister with information, sister with facts, okay? Something that you can work with. A sister with something that you need, she give you some information that you can work with. Thank you. I appreciate that. I'm so happy you came by. I really am, misunderstood. You should come by even more often. You know, John said he's uploading videos now, so I went up there and subscribed. I told him he needs to hit the live button. Okay, I'm encouraging him to hit the live button. And when he does, I will be there. I will be there because I'm subscribed. Matter of fact, I'm going to go over there and make sure I have all the notifications together because, you know, I don't want to miss a thing because I literally will miss a thing. I got to get better about running these streets. People tell me all the time, like, Saidi, you need to get out a little bit more, hit some panels, start, you know, engaging a little more. So, you know, I'm going to take the advice and I'm gonna get to that, but maybe not so much today because, you know, I'll be over there at Tracy's for the most part, or Olivia the Oracle. You know, I roam in the beef sector a little bit, you know. Outside of that, I kind of like, you know, anyways. But anyways, thank y'all for coming. I will be back. Maybe I might be back tomorrow. I don't know. Maybe. Don't hold me to it, okay, you guys? Because I don't want to be a liar. It's a possibility, though. All right, y'all. I'll see you next time. Bye.